This program is one of dignity and respect and acknowledgement. We expect that every student and every guest is here today to bring honor to the students who have achieved so much. And therefore, we know that the behavior and the conduct of every person in the room will be exemplary. I do not expect to have to stop at any time during the program. It should run smoothly. So I appreciate your cooperation, and I know that we will all be very proud to be part of this assembly today. Please welcome the administration of the yeshiva. Please welcome the students who are being inducted into the 2015 Archon Assembly today.
Service.
Everybody has a chair. You have a seat?
Okay, good. All right. And now, please join me in welcoming the administration of the Yeshiva of Flatbush, Joel Braverman High School.
Thank you.
is on the sides. Shh. Okay. We are now going to stand for the national anthem played by the orchestra under the direction of Mr. Joel Hessel. Please remain standing
throughout the national anthem, as well as the invocation read by Michael Asher Lifshitz in Hebrew and in English by Emma Burakovich. Rochelle Gersh and Lior Ojeda will follow with a prayer for the United States and Israel. After they have finished, at that point, you will be seated. Please remain standing and respectful throughout the opening program.
Psalm by David. Hashem, who may sojourn in your tent? Who may dwell on your holy mountain? One who walks in perfect innocence, and who does what is right, and speaks the truth from his heart, who has no slander on his tongue, who has done his fellow no evil, nor cast disgrace upon his close one, in whose eyes a contemptible person is repulsive, but who honors those who fear Hashem, who can swear to his detriment without retracting, who lends not his money on interest, nor takes a bribe against the innocent. The doer of these shall not falter forever.
Avinu Shebashamai, uphold and bless the United States of America, and view brotherly love among all those who dwell within our land. Bless the constituted officers of government and members of its armed forces. Set in their hearts the spirit of wisdom and understanding to uphold peace and freedom.
Avinu Shebashamayim, Tzur Yisrael v'Goalo, Barech et Medinat Yisrael, Reshit Tzmichat Geulatenu. Hagen aleha be'evrat chasdecha, ufros aleha sukat shalomecha, ushlach orecha v'amitecha lerasheha, שריה ויועציה ותקנה בעצה טובה מלפניך. ואת אחינו, כל בית ישראל, פקוד נא בכל ארצות פזוריהם, ותוליכה מהרה קוממיות לציון עיריך, ולירושלים משכן שמך.
Thank you. Please be seated. The yeshiva is known for its outstanding administrators and teachers whose professionalism is unparalleled in Jewish education. Today, I am privileged to introduce our Rosh HaYeshiva, head of school, Rabbi Dr. Raymond Harari. He is a master teacher and a scholar devoted to the yeshiva, its faculty, and students. He is an inspiring and visionary leader whose untiring efforts enable all of us to fulfill the yeshiva's mission and core values. Rabbi Harari.
Good morning, everybody. Welcome to the Yeshiva of Flatbush for this wonderful ceremony this morning. Rabbi Akiva, echad megidolei ha-tanaim, haya omer, haviv adam shenivra betzelem, chiba yetera nodat lo shenivra betzelem elokim, shenemar ki betzelem elokim asa et ha-adam. Man and woman were created in God's image. Sometimes people see this simply as trumpeting human beings' preeminence over the animals, as something to boast about and to gloat about. But I see it very differently. Being created in the image of God places responsibilities and obligations upon us. To name just a few, it means living a life always in search of meaning. It means to apply reason to everything that we do, to think hard and always before we act, to respect our souls and our bodies by insisting that we grow in wisdom every day at the same time that we pursue healthy and safe lifestyles. And perhaps most significantly for this moment, we're supposed to always recognize that all of us were created in God's image. And I repeat, all of us were created in God's image as well. And therefore, we are always supposed to recognize that everyone, the scholar and the simpleton, the affluent and the indigent, deserve our respect, our compassion, and our care. And at the same time, we're supposed to realize when we understand what it means to be created in God's image, that we have to realize that some people require more attention and more love than others. The creation of man and woman in God's image is one of the core values here at the Yeshiva of Flatbush, and it forms the foundation of what it means to be inducted into Archon. To develop one's abilities to the fullest and beyond, to learn how to lead and work productively and cooperatively with others of like and even of unlike minds, to use our talents to touch the lives of others, particularly those who are less fortunate. We extend our congratulations this morning to all the Archon inductees, to their parents, to their grandparents, to the family members who've come to spend this wonderful morning with us, and we wish them many years of leadership, service, and active, constructive involvement in this great world that we live in.
Thank you, Rabbi Harari. We are pleased today that Rabbi Seth Linfield, Executive Director of the Yeshiva, and Mr. Robert Frastai, President of the Yeshiva, are able to join us. Mr. Frastai, himself a graduate of the high school, was on the stage for more than one occasion when he was here. And today he represents the lay leadership in his words to you.
You rabbis, honored guests, and most of all, our Archon inductees. I'm often asked, what is it about the Yeshiva of Flatbush that makes it special? And I respond with a very short statement. I call it the Flatbush experience. The Flatbush experience is not just about our classes. It's not just about academics. It's not just about our world-class faculty. It's not just the learning that goes on in the classroom, all of which are critically important, to be sure. But my personal view of what makes the Flatbush experience is what you see when you flip through this book. It's about the extracurricular activities. It's about giving our students, regardless of where they fit in the academic hierarchy, the ability to find something that is important to them, that they're passionate about, and that they can grow with. It also gives our students, and our honorees here, the ability to give something back to our school and to their classmates even while they're here. At the end of the day, what makes this group so very special is that they've taken from their time, with no credit other than perhaps this assembly, to make our school a better place, whether it's through drama, the arts, choir. I mean, just flip through these pages. It goes on and on. So to them, I say thank you. I say mabruk, I say mazal tov. I have no doubt that one day it will be you up here, or one of you up here, giving this speech to the next generation of Archon inductees. Because it is my sincere hope that both our students up here on the stage and our students out there in the audience will always remember their time at the Yeshiva of Flatbush when they ultimately graduate and take and find their passion for giving back both to the Yeshiva and to our communities, because we all benefit when that happens. So again, I'd like to say Mabruk and Mazal Tov to our inductees, to their parents, and to all of us. We're all better off because of them. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Frastai. As you will hear today over and over, I am sure, to be a Flatbush student means to get involved and to do something that will have a positive effect on another person as well as on yourself, whether it be in the school or in the community at large, Israel, or in the whole world. You can make a difference, and you can have that effect that makes a difference for other people. You, the students, the faculty advisors, create a culture of caring and commitment that is at the core of the yeshiva. Recently, we were very fortunate that one of our graduates, Jake Novak, a supervising producer for Power Lunch at CNBC, he wrote an article, What Makes an Elite School?, in which he writes about his experiences in a private prep elementary school in Virginia and in high school here at the Yeshiva of Flatbush. He gives a lot of credit to parents, and we must give them credit today too, for making the right choice for their children's education. Kol hakavod to all of the parents and the grandparents who supported all the students, whether on stage or in the audience, in making the Yeshiva of Flatbush their choice for their children's education. And kol hakavod for supporting them throughout the years, whether it's helping them with homework or driving them to an event, whatever it is, it's because the parents and the families make this a joint experience. Mr. Novak, he actually says that while it's also important to have a very rigorous classroom curriculum, young people must be taught that they have to find a purpose greater than grades, greater than financial gain, and greater than themselves. And he believes that the variety of achievements and high levels of success among Flatbush alumni is a direct result of his teacher's efforts to make sure that he and his peers grew up to be productive and valuable members of the Jewish community. And that's what it means to be a student at the Yeshiva of Flatbush. And that's why we have Archon, to encourage students to find a purpose greater than themselves and to connect and to tie them to Jewish and communal life. And to be honored at this Archon program is a goal that is within the reach of every one of you sitting in the audience today. While we honor the outstanding commitment of the students on the stage, we also recognize the many teachers and students listed in your program who gave of their time to organize, participate, lead, and advise activities and events that are so much part of our life here in the yeshiva. We begin with one of the most significant contributors, and that is the SGO. Ms. Sarah Marcus, advisor, with the help of the current SGO, Victor, Robin, Junie, Michael, and Sophia, will inaugurate the new officers for the school year 2015-16. Everyone, outgoing and incoming, please come to the podium. Woo!
Hi. It's the oldest story in the world. One day you're 17 and planning for someday, and then quietly, without you really noticing it, someday is today, and then someday is yesterday, and this is your life. There are always a million things to do. There's always a million things going on at any given moment, and Flatbush is no exception. Being busy at Flatbush is the norm. We come early, we stay late, and we participate in all the extracurricular and extra opportunities that make a part of what makes this school so special. Can you tell I'm nervous? I'm a little nervous. Okay, listen. Let's be honest here. It's not a secret that I love this school. I loved it so much that I came back to teach and be part of the magic that fills this building and fills the student body every single day. There's always something going on, and there's something in the atmosphere we create here that's just a little magical. There's really no other place in the world like this. As a teacher here, it's inspiring to be part of such an amazing place. We all work together to help our students find their spark, their Tselem Elohim, and their special talent that makes them unique. This current SGO is my first, and we have all learned and grown so much from this experience. I learned about Snapchat, emojis, OCD charts, and what it really, really means to be a leader. Victor, Robin, Junie, Sophia, Michael, you've taught me more about myself than I can ever really admit in front of 800 people, and for that, I am eternally grateful. You have grown to flourish and be leaders and role models for the rest of the student body. We are happy to see you go off to bigger and better, but we are sorry to see you leave. I'm going to finish off by telling you a quick story. I remember sitting in the back of the auditorium a few years ago and watching Miss Zeriker run the closing ceremonies of Color War. And all I could think was, someday I will accomplish that. Someday I will stand up in front of a crowd full of pride and joy and a little humility at the amazing accomplishments of our student body. And while I have nowhere near filled the shoes of my predecessor, I am proud to stand here and tell you that I saw my someday, and I reached for it, and I held on tightly. It's the oldest story in the world. One day you're 17, and you're planning for someday, and then quietly, without you really noticing it, that someday is today, and that someday is yesterday, and this is your life. As the current SGO could tell you, the year passes by more quickly than you really think. So take advantage of all the chances to let yourself shine and cultivate your unique talents and explore the world around you and yourself, and you will never know what you can discover. So make the most of your everyday here at Flatbush. All the choices you make as a student, they matter. So go and seize those moments and find your someday. So without further ado, I would like to introduce the outgoing SGO, Victor Zaytouni, Robin. Yeah. Michael, Junie, and Sophia.
Good morning, rabbis, teachers, parents, fellow classmates, and students. April 9th, 2014 was just a regular day for most students sitting in this auditorium, but for five juniors, it meant they would represent the students of the Yeshiva of Flatbush. On April 9th, we were called down to our Levy's office to hear the news. The news had been a change for all of us. There were not going to be four SGO members, but rather there'd be five of us. Not only were there five of us, but we also had a new advisor. Mrs. Marcus showed her enthusiasm and excitement for our first meeting. Mrs. Marcus's great ideas made it seem like she worked with SGO for years beforehand. As we walked out of Rabbi Levy's office, in seconds, we grew as a family. We all ran to the auditorium and blurted out all our ideas for the coming year. We worked together to plan and create amazing events for the students. We met during lunch at least three times a week, and sometimes even more. We spent hours on Google Hangout and even a few nights at Mrs. Marcus's house. This year was full of many events, starting with our integrity wall to Hanukkah Fair, to Battle of the Band, Color War, and last but not least, Lag B'Omer special event.
Our biggest event was Color War. When we were told to plan a five-day Color War, the ideas and thoughts that ran through all of our heads were crazy. But at the end of the day, we wanted to plan the most amazing, inspiring Color War for all of the students. From Friday afternoon until Tuesday night, students worked together creating a hallway, banner, Dvar Torah, dance, and cheer that represented their themes. The themes this year were persistence, confidence, heritage, and knowledge. One might ask, what do all these things have in common? The answer is our motto, stand tall. When times are tough, what motivates all of us to stand tall? We realize that all our hard work, countless meetings, and sleepless nights paid off When we walked around the school during Color War, we were able to see the outstanding passion and talent of our student body. With Color War, we created a unity that transcended all grades and faculty members. If you would ask any one of us about SGL, we wouldn't change a thing. We would do it all over in a heartbeat.
The students, as well as six of us, thought that Color War would be our last event before the new SGL was elected. We were getting very antsy to do another event, and as Lagba Arm was approaching, we saw it as a perfect opportunity to do another event. We came with a few activities, and out of those, picked the best ones to incorporate into the event. We kept it a surprise. We had a bouncy house, blind musical chairs, knockout, as well as fresh popcorn, cotton candy, and super pretzels. As students were called down by Reverend Levy, their faces lit up when they saw and smelled that the SGL was added again.
This year, we did things a little differently. We strived tirelessly to support and encourage creative expression. From a reconstitution of Battle of the Bands, which provided a refreshed template for musical expression, to our kindness initiative and kindness cards, which inspired resounding expressions of kindness and compassion, we were devoted to making each and every student find their moments to shine.
Our goal as SGL was to make sure the students enjoyed school. SGL taught us a lot of things, but the thing we learned the most was teamwork. If anyone asks us what we learned from SGO, we wouldn't be able to give them just one answer. Firstly, not only did we get lucky this year with a five-person team, but we also got to work with the best people in the world. Everyone's talents were brought to life when we each came together to plan an event. Again, what we learned the most was teamwork. If just one of us was missing, the events we planned wouldn't be nearly the same. During our weekly meetings, the absence of just one member was deeply noted and made for a much quieter meeting already. We can't explain how happy we are to have had this kind of experience, because not only did we learn how to coordinate and lead events with more experience, but we've created an unbreakable bond of love and respect. We would like to thank Rabbi Levy, Mrs. Marcus, but most of all, each and every one of you. Thank you. Okay.
And therefore, it is my honor to pass on the reins to the new SGO. Tradition tells us that in order to do that, we pass on an how-to binder, in which we explain all the events we did, the corrections we would have made, and how they could do it better to give you a better year next year. And therefore, I'm happy to introduce to you President Danielle Ashkenazi, Vice President Esther Cohen, Treasurer Joe Valciano, and Secretary Moe Levy.
Thank you guys for electing us, and next year is going to be great.
I can't wait. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Marcus, SGO 2014-15, and we look forward to the achievements and the initiatives of the new SGO. The first award today, is the Peer Tutoring Award established in memory of Donna Becker, Allah Shalom, a beloved member of our office staff. Rabbi Ronald Levy, Principal of the Yeshiva, will make this presentation.
Where is it?
The first one on
this
top.
One?
Yes. There's the one inside.
This. Okay. I'd like to also take this opportunity to congratulate the parents, grandparents, friends of the family, and to congratulate the multitude of faculty members who supervise and head all of the very, very special programs and activities that you see listed in the brochure. Without faculty advisors, both within the school and faculty and from outside who join us, none of this would be possible. I'd also like to take this opportunity to tell you that over the last 2.5-3 weeks, and probably over the last 5 months in terms of theory, Mrs. Sanders has worked so hard together with Mr. Galpert and so many other people to make this happen this morning. So I want to congratulate her as well. What did you say? Yeah. And of course, Mrs. Sanders is only half a person without Maya Cohn. About a week ago, what I missed. What I missed. Okay, let me in on the joke later. About a week ago. Oh. You guys know if you push me hard enough, I might just break out into singing it. Last week, I discovered that my stapler was missing off my desk. And the sense of loss was not because it was late in the day and it was another challenging day, but because that stapler had belonged to a woman that I worked with for 15 years, who was my right hand, my secretary. It had her name on it still from when she put it on there with her piece of tape. And it was my link and my connection to her every single day. Donna Becker was a main cog in the functioning of the office staff. But beyond that, she was a person who cared about the growth of every child, not just in the school, but anyone that she came in contact with throughout her life. But she focused primarily on children who had special needs and who needed an additional touch of love and kindness and support. And therefore, we use this opportunity to recognize a student annually who demonstrates that kind of concern above and beyond themselves in helping other students in our yeshiva. It is the Donna Becker Memorial Award for Peer Tutoring being presented today to Abby Shegelman. Presented to Abby Shegelman, as a peer tutor, you have provided service above and beyond the expected, giving of your time and knowledge in a spirit of true chesed. You have been a caring and supportive friend, helping fellow students succeed in specific subjects and assignments, and to master the challenges of high school study. Donna Becker, Aleha Shalom, extended friendship to our students and took a personal interest in their lives. Your commitment is a heartwarming affirmation of those qualities. Archon exercises, May 29, 2015, 11 Sivan 5775. Mazal tov, mabruk. Mazal tov and mabruk to all of the inductees, to all the parents, and I got my stapler back.
Thank you, Rabbi Levy. Congratulations, Mazal Tov, to Abby. We have two special awards this year. The first one is being given by Rabbi Besser, Dean of Students.
Boker Tov, Mazal Tov to the beautiful students, to the parents, to the grandparents, and Mabruk. I hope I'm safe by starting the story 2 weeks ago. Is that a remix or is that okay? I don't know. So 2 weeks ago, I was very inspired when 55 students, a full bus, volunteered to go on a Sunday in a free time, spend 6 hours to the Special Children's Center to bring a smile and a happy moment to children with special needs. But I was even more inspired when I went down the list and I mentioned to the students how many hours they're going to be, get chesed hours they're going to be earning. A number of the students said to me, oh, we don't need hours, we're way done. We came for the mitzvah. That was very inspiring. And I think that's what we're celebrating today. We're celebrating the concept of volunteerism, of chesed, of caring, way beyond hours and way beyond earning reward. And I think the goal or the point is really understood with a quick anecdote, a quick story that impacted me and some of the parents who are actually sitting in the audience today on a trip that we took a couple of weeks ago to Israel. And we were very, very lucky, I guess, to interact with an organization and a program called Special in Uniform. This is an organization started by a colonel in the Israeli army, Tiran Atiyah, who realized that there are some young men and women who are not necessarily fully functioning, as they say, but they are functioning, but still with special needs, who feel bad that they're not part of the Israeli army or the IDF. So in his wisdom and his compassion, he opened up 11 units. In our words, he started Yachad in the Israeli army. And there are 11 units right now in 11 bases where special needs young men and women are part of the army and given their special assignments so they could feel that they're part of what's happening in the state of Israel. We were lucky to visit the top army base. It was an Air Force base. And we saw how this program worked. And in the question and answer moment, one of our participants asked the colonel, it's an Air Force base, top of the line, discipline. How do the soldiers here take to the fact that there is a chesed program? And very quickly, the colonel looked at us and said, our soldiers are better soldiers because of that unit. That's what we're celebrating today. We have gone and reached a point that we understand that we are better people, better students, better children, better fathers and mothers, and reach our potential when we reach out to someone else. And I'm very proud of that. I think that our students are lucky that they have unbelievable faculty role models who also understand that this is not a 9-to-5 situation, that we go beyond the classroom and beyond our given time to reach out to the students. It is my honor to recognize one of those teachers, and that teacher is Ms. Ariella Robinson. I'm going to read what it says. I don't understand half these words, but I'm going to read them anyway. Ariella, as a teacher, you have helped to gather facts and evaluate ideas, but as an advisor and mentor, you have implanted in our hearts a love of learning as a process of discovery, benefit, and passion. Your creative influence has been felt far beyond the classroom. You initiated the Ladies Wellness Program to support a healthy lifestyle, including yoga, camping, and a commitment to community life. This experiential approach enabled your students to become confident and capable in their personal growth. Under your aegis, Pegasus has soared up to new heights as a national award-winning literary and art magazine. Your leadership and guidance gave students the opportunity to shine as writers and artists. As you continue to encourage and inspire our students to find their voices and express themselves, you offered them the competitive world of poetry slam, in which they became an acclaimed oral storytellers. At the pinnacle of these great achievements, your life has taken a new direction. Did you get that? Towards marriage and Israel. The indelible mark that you have made on us and within and on the walls of the yeshiva will remain with us always. We will miss you and your unique appreciation for education, talent, and imagination. Kihine, I got some Hebrew. Kihine yotzer harim uvore ruach umagid ladam masecho. For behold, he forms mountains, creates winds, he recounts to a person what were his deeds, Ariella Robinson.
Thank you so much. I look out of all at all these faces, and I just want you to know, as a teacher, it's kind of like investing knowledge into your minds. You never know what you're gonna profit off it. You probably will profit nothing off of it, but you hope that what you put into everyone goes out and spreads something positive and happiness and something good for the world. And the people behind me, I feel, have done that, and I feel will continue to do that, and I feel like the people in front of me can only do that too. So thank you so much.
Thank you, Rabbi. Ms. Robinson, we really will miss you. The second special award will be presented by Mrs. Shifra Hannon. Although Mrs. Hannon is no longer in the classroom, she reaches every student, every single student in the yeshiva through her work as coordinator of our Pathfinders Career Mentoring Program. Today, she also celebrates the achievements of her granddaughter, Florence, who is on stage as an Archon inductee. Mrs. Hannon.
Thank you so much for this wonderful opportunity. I would like to call Michael Zalta to the stage. I can't begin to state the pride and just the overwhelming feeling of gratitude to have known Michael when he came in as a freshman. Mrs. Sanders had this wonderful concept to go to nursing homes and Michael to use his talent. And Michael took it to another level. I want to also thank Vicki and Jack Aney for making it possible by supporting us. And I'd like to read what's on the plaque. Okay, presented to Michael Zalta, Ashira Lashem Bahayai Azamra Leilokei Beodei. You are blessed with an extraordinary vocal and acting talent which illuminated many school productions and Evening of the Art audiences. They were thrilled, but you continue to search for personal meaning and fulfillment. Several years ago, you discovered that using your gifts to bring joy to the elderly or the ill was more important than applause. You began performing on Friday afternoons in nursing homes. Your early productions were done in solo format, which when you were compelled to abandon a more and more proficient students became part of your exciting enterprise, and thus was created the Traveling Troupe. Today, the Traveling Troupe has grown to 90 talented students waiting for the call to entertain, a group which you organized, continue to shape with your creativity into an unforgettable experience of song, dance, and drama that fills the hearts and frees the spirit. You are graduating, but the troupe continues to follow your lead and pursue your goals. We wish you bracha v'hatzlacha on behalf of the many audiences you have elevated and the students, faculty, and administration of the Yeshiva Flatbush Joel Braverman High School.
Thank you, Mrs. Hannon. Kol hakavod, Michael, and kol hakavod to all the students who participate in this wonderful program. And thank you to the Aineys for making it a priority in their lives to keep this program going. Ms. Sari Bacon, Associate Principal, will now introduce the Archon video.
Hi, everybody. I too want to wish congratulations and my gratitude to everybody, of course, on stage, all the faculty advisors, and especially I'm looking out at the audience to our future Archon inductees, looking at the ninth grade, looking forward to the day that you will be up here behind us as well. I have the pleasure of introducing a video that will share just a glimpse of the rich extracurricular life at the yeshiva. This amazing video was produced by the multi-talented Rochelle Gersh with photos culled from the collections of many of our students. The following presentation is just a small sample of the richness and variety of experiences and opportunities in the yeshiva and the great work that our students do. There is so much more than what you see on the screen, and we ask you to please be sure to read the daily update and follow us on Twitter, Facebook, and myflatbushlife.com. Enjoy.
Hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you again, Rochelle. Thank you, Ms. Bacon. Rabbi Joseph Beta, assistant principal and senior grade advisor, will introduce the students' view.
Thank you, Mrs. Sanders, and I want to congratulate you on a wonderful program this morning. Of course, extending my congratulations as well to all the Archon inductees, their families, and the whole yeshiva community. It's a beautiful moment, and it's a beautiful day. When I think about Archon, one word always comes to mind, and that's pride. I think today, above all days in the school calendar, is a day that we feel a sense of pride in our students, because the people that are up here generally are up here not for self-interested reasons, not so that they could further their careers, not so that they could get good grades, but that so that they can contribute to the lives of the community, of their fellow students, of the world at large. And it's a beautiful thing, it's a wonderful thing about our yeshiva. This morning, I'm filled with a tremendous sense of pride to be able to introduce one of my students to be able to speak to you. Not long ago, he sat in your seat as a freshman, a sophomore, and as a junior. And he too had pride in the yeshiva, and he too cared a lot. And the student that I'm going to introduce to you is one of the more thoughtful, kind students that I've met in my many years here at the yeshiva. And he took that kindness and that thoughtfulness and he coupled it with a tremendous amount of effort on your behalf, on behalf of all the students in the school, in order to make your lives a heck of a lot better. So without further ado, I'd like to introduce to you, to present how he got here, our SGO president, Mr. Victor Zatuna.
Have you ever worked so hard to accomplish something? You put in the time, you put in the effort, and you dedicated so much of yourself because you knew that it would be worth it. You came this close to success. In fact, for a while, you actually thought you achieved it. If you've ever felt this way, you know how terrible it feels. And if you didn't, I hope you never do. Unfortunately, yet fortunately, it probably will happen to you. As a sophomore, I was lucky enough to make the Model UN team. Why I tried out? Until today, I really have no idea. I think my mom told me to try out or something. Well, that's besides the point. I was one of seven kids who made the team, chosen from over 70 students who tried out. But what I didn't realize was the commitment that came with making this team. We had practices for 6 months every Sunday morning from 9 to 12. You miss one practice, you're off the team. And that's all besides the work and the preparation and the research you have to do on your own time. But when I got to that conference, when I stood up there to make my speeches, I was on top of my game. And after 3 long days of debate, came the award ceremony. I was ready. I knew they'd call my name for best delegate. And as I got ready to run up there, they called someone else's name. All right, it's life. It happens. But I couldn't believe it. How is it that after months and months of work and preparation and dedication, I had nothing to show for what I did? I can't say I have an answer to this question, and I can't say I can answer anyone who's been disappointed in life. That's it, it's life. There will always be someone who could do what you do, and they could probably do it better. I'm sorry to break it to you, but there is one thing you can do better than anyone else, and that's be you. We spend all our time preoccupied with trying to impress other people, with trying to fit in. We do things because they're the cool thing to do, or because everyone else is doing it. But when we get too concerned with these things, we never discover who we truly are. For some random reason, I like to follow quotes on Instagram. But don't worry, I will never like any of those pictures, because God forbid someone should know what I do on Instagram. It's like when you're scrolling through someone's account and 68 weeks ago, and you're making sure not to like their picture. Either way, when I was feeling really down, scrolling through my Instagram feed, I read something that hit me. It said, in the end, you will only regret the chances you never took. And that's how I changed my outlook. It's crazy, but it was really that simple. I realized that it was on my job, it was on me to find activities, to find programs, to find commissions and things that I did because they made me, me. After all, it was in my hands to achieve success. It wasn't in someone else's to give it to me. And I decided that I'd rather look back on my high school and I'd rather look back on my life and say, I can't believe I did that, overlooking and saying, I really wish I would have done that. Why didn't I try? Sometimes you really won't succeed though. I didn't always. But the thing is, you have to use that failure. You have to use the times that you're down as motivation to achieve greatness. And when you realize that you have zero idea what greatness actually means, you learn that the only way to achieve it is to try everything. And trust me, it's never too late. I was that kid who wouldn't go on seminar. But in senior year, I took that leap of faith, and I loved it. And really, I went 3 times this year. And the only thing that was different between me in freshman year on seminar and me in senior year on seminar was the change in my mentality. It was the change in me. And that's my message. If there's anything I could share with you today, if there's one thing I could tell you, it's about stepping up to the plate and trying new things. Whether it's as simple as going to a Tzedakah Commission meeting in 4:05 on a Wednesday, or as hard as making a team and committing to constant practices. I really know you won't love everything, but that's why I'm telling you to try everything that crosses your path. And it's in your hands to discover who you truly are and what you are capable of. 3 years later, I am proud to say that I got my Best Delegate Award, and I got another award for Outstanding Delegate as well. But why did I try out? Again, I have no idea, but the difference is that I took a chance, and I was able to find something I love. Speaking, debating, presenting, or really anything that involves me speaking for that matter. But I only found it because I was willing to try something new and to keep trying. On this stage before you are a group of seniors, and we honor them because of what they accomplished and because of who they are. It's no coincidence that we do this in front of the whole school. If you really think about it, it should really just be a group of seniors sitting here in front of you, in front of us. But we do it to show you that it's in your hands to step up to the plate. It's in your hands to merit the honor of sitting here, and it's in your hands to achieve success. And the only thing that's stopping you, the only force in your way, is you. As a student at Flatbush, as a person living in the crazy world we live in today, we know that nothing is impossible. So go for it. Grow, achieve, try, and most importantly, find out for yourself who you truly are. Thank you.
All right, thank you, Victor. I think everyone got the message. So we expect more students next year and in the coming years to be sitting on stage with us. The highest Archon Service Award was established in honor of Rabbi Dr. David Eliach when he retired after serving as principal of the yeshiva for over 40 years. If you are in the library on Tuesday or Thursday, you can see that Rabbi Eliach is still a vital part of the yeshiva. He is a teacher's teacher now, working with faculty on curriculum and methodology. Although he's not in school today, he is able to address you from his seat in the library, thanks to modern technology and the assistance of Joey Baum.
זה 60 שנה שאני יושב על הבמה של פלטבוש באספות שונות, וזו הפעם הראשונה שאני מדבר עליכם ולא רואה אתכם. ולכן הפעם אוכל לומר דברים שרק בצינה אומרים אותם. אני יודע שחלק גדול מההורים הם מסיימי פלטבוש וחברי ארקן, ואני אומר לכם בכל הלב, שכחתי כל מעשי הקונדס שלכם, and I love you all. כל מי שלמד בישיבת פלטבוש יש לו זכות מיוחדת. כי זכה ללמוד באחת הישיבות הטובות ביותר בארצות הברית. ומדוע הישיבה שלנו היא מן הטובות ביותר? כי אלה היושבים על הבמה היום, חברי הארקן, מעידים על כך. העדות שלהם כי בישיבת פלטבוש לא רק מלמדים, אלא מחנכים להיות אנשים הגונים. בהרבה ישיבות לומדים, משחקים בספורט, מתקבלים באוניברסיטה, אבל מעט ישיבות, ואולי אנחנו יחידים בזה, שמקדישים אסמבלי לארקן, לתלמידים העושים ומכירים תודה, היודעים לא רק לקבל, אלא גם לתת. הישיבה שלנו יודעת את הסוד של הכרת הטוב, שאמור מעט ועשה הרבה, הוא חשוב. וכל זה יוצר את האדם השלם. אני יודע שבקהל יושבים הרבה הורים שגם כן היו בארקן ולמדו וקיימו הכרת הטוב לאחרים וגם לישיבה. ואתם דואגים שגם הדורות הבאים ילמדו ויקבלו חינוך יהודי שלם. היו גאים שזכיתם ללמוד בישיבה. ועכשיו הבנים והבנות שלכם לומדים במקום תורה ודרך ארץ, וגם הם בעל כאן. למרות הבעיות שיש לישיבה לתקן, ההנהלה והמורים יושבים בכובד ראש כדי לפתור את הבעיות. הם עובדים במסירות ובלב הנפש להביא את הישיבה לשלב העליון ביותר. בגלל שיש לנו הנהלה כזאת וחבר מורים כזה ובעלי בתים ותלמידים כה רבים בארקן היודעים לתת ולא רק לקבל, שיודעים לוותר על האיגו ולתרום זמן וכסף, נגיע בעזרת השם לשלבים עליונים ביותר. ואסיים בדבר תורה. בפרשת נשא אנו מוצאים את ברכת כהנים המורכבת משלוש ברכות בשלבים שונים ובהדרגה. יברכך השם וישמרך. השם מברך אבל לא מופיע. יאר השם פניו אליך ויחונקה. השם מפנה פניו אל העם, מתקרב יותר אבל לא לגמרי. ובסוף יישא השם פניו אליך, כאילו נושא פניו ומגיש לכם אותו. תלמיד הנכנס לישיבת פלטבוש בתחילה מרגיש זרות ולא מכיר את כל הטוב. בשלב השני רואה את הדברים היפים והטובים בישיבה, ובסוף נושא על כפיים כל מה שקיבל ויוצא לחיים. וישם לך שלום. אני מברך את כל אנשי ארקן בשלום והצלחה. All the Arkan students are wonderful, but there is always one who rises above the rest. The student who is receiving the award this year has participated in over 40 activities and programs. I am proud to present this award to David Ayri.
Now for Rabbi Eliach. No. David Ayri, by an unusual measure of friendship and help, you have shown constant devotion to fellow students and to making our yeshiva a better place of learning and personal growth. You have set high standards of chesed and menschlichkeit, which is to be a whole and wonderful human being, which others may well emulate. And this should hang in your office someday, yes. Too. Mazal tov, David. Mazal to your parents also. Okay. Put that down and get ready to come here. This year we have a unique opportunity to share an important recognition with all of our students and guests. Mr. Galpert will explain.
I first want to say mazal tov and mabruk to everyone who's standing behind me and everyone who's sitting in front of me, to the parents and families for supporting the students throughout all years. Today we have a special opportunity to call up a group of seniors who have worked countless amount of hours and put in a great deal of dedication to put together a book that culminates their years at Flatbush. So I call up the editors of the yearbook 2015, David Ayri, Rochelle Gersh, Emma Berkovich, wow. Shani Zendelman, and Sarah Levy.
It is my great honor and privilege to be able to announce the dedication of our yearbook. Summit 2015 is hereby dedicated to Mrs. Sarah Ovadia. Senora, please join us on stage. We present to you this plaque.
Zara, come here. What it took you to come Wednesday night, what it took to get you to come Wednesday night.
We present to you this plaque which reads, our theme of clarity is personified by Mrs. Sarah Ovadia, a.k.a. Senora, a.k.a. Mommy. As an alumna of the yeshiva, Senora Ovadia has never lost her true Flatbush self of wanting to be involved and influential. Senora embodies the character of a true educator. The influence she has on her students has no end. Whether it's after class or any other time of the day, Senora is always there to help when she can.
Her unique talent of being able to connect with all the students she interacts with allows her to guide the next generation of leaders on a pathway of faith in themselves and emunah in Hashem. She does this by instilling the values of clarity in life that is achieved by being kind to family, friends, and those around us, as well as teaching us to use the Torah as a guide to life.
If you are lucky enough to have Senora Ovadia freshman or sophomore year, or for Spanish 3, you not only learned the basics of Spanish, but also the importance of appreciating cultural diversity in a globalized world. Besides for teaching her students how to sing the Spanish alphabet in under 1 minute and how to conjugate verbs, Senora has also taught all of us what it means to be a person of chesed, whether it's a tournament or fundraiser for the Tzedakah Commission or visiting the elderly. Senora is always on the forefront to help students learn what it means to live a life of chesed.
It was never just about the hours, but rather it was all about stressing the importance of understanding the acts of kindness which we do. She helps us understand that to live in a world with Torah and Midot, we must not only love God, but respect and reach out to those around us.
Moreover, Senora Ovadia is someone that any student can feel comfortable with and depend on. We are honored to dedicate this yearbook to our role model, mentor, and inspiration. Thank you, Senora, for being a true example of how a member of our community and nation should act.
Okay.
Okay, so picture first, hug later.
Mazal tov, mabruk to Mrs. Ovadia and to the staff of the summit, this year's yearbook, which is going to be available soon and is a beautiful production. Okay, guys? We're good, you all right? We will complete the Archon induction ceremony by acknowledging every candidate and his or her activities. Oh, you want to say something?
Yes.
Come say something. We'll take a moment.
Oh my God, I don't know what to say. Oh my God. Wow, in Spanish. Okay. Wow. Oh my goodness. I have no words. I just want to thank the yearbook staff and the principals and the school and the teachers and the parents for giving me the zchut to do what I do here. It's a zchut. Every day walking into this building and seeing these faces that I adore, and you know I adore you, just makes my life. I wouldn't be who I am without the Yeshiva Flatbush and without you guys, every single one of you. I love you. Thank you.
Well deserved. And now we will go to the completion of the Archon induction ceremony by acknowledging every student's activities. Please hold your applause till the end. I know that's hard, but it helps. It goes quickly. We have on the video screen the picture, the name, and the activities. And we have to thank David Idy, one of the many things that he did We have to thank him for putting this video together for us.
וזכני לגדך בוני ובני בוני חכמי ונבוני אוי אבי השם יראי אלוקי אנשי אמץ זרע קודש בהשם דבקי toyrom uv masim toyvim uv khol melakh savoyda savoyre mirim asoyla matoyrom uv masim toyvim uv khol melakh savoyda savoyre
Let's give everyone a big round of applause. Lights. We will now induct these candidates into the Archon Society. Inductees, please stand. I will recite the Archon Pledge on their behalf. Anachnu hamumadim, makirim heitev et matrot ha'irgun, umizdahim im matrotav, lazor befituach haverav, mevchina ruchanit vegufanit, לגדוג לטובת בית הספר התיכון של ישיבת פלאפוש, מצהירים בזה שנעשה כמיטב יכולתנו לטובת ארגון ארכון. We being fully acquainted with the purpose of Archon and being in full sympathy with its aim to support only those things which look to the highest development, physically and spiritually, of its members and to the good of the yeshiva of Flatbush Joel Braverman High School, hereby pledge to use our best efforts to promote the welfare of Archon. You are now officially members of the Archon Service Society. Congratulations, mazal tov, mabruk. Stay standing, don't sit, don't sit. Right. The closing benediction will be read in Hebrew by Merle Cohn and in English by Jack Sasson. Okay, please do not applaud after the benediction. We will then proceed to sing Hatikva, and the recessional will follow. There is a lovely collation for the administration and the Archon honorees and their guests in the Beit Midrash. The collation is sponsored by Rabbi Ezra and Shifra Hannon in honor of their granddaughter Florence, Jaime and Liza Shama in honor of their son Michael, and Eric and Suzanne Sasson in honor of their son Jack. Please, students, in the audience, please allow the administration and the Archon honorees to exit the auditorium first. The parents and family members will follow them. You will please wait. Stay in the auditorium, in your seats, and wait for further instructions. Okay? Closing benediction, followed by Hatikva. Thank you all. Shabbat Shalom. Please stand.
Don't stop those talking.
Yep.
Say one word and then repeat. All
right, please.
Merle smiles.
Shir Hama'alot Le David. Hine matov umanaim shevet achim gam yachad. Keshemen hatov al harosh, yored al hazakan, zakan aharon, shiered al pimidotav, ketalcher mon, shiored al hareretzion, kisham siva hashem et habracha chaim ad haolam.
A Song of Ascents by David. Behold, how good and how pleasant is the dwelling of brothers. Moreover, in unity, like the precious oil upon the head running down upon the beard of Aaron, running down over his garments, like the dew of Hermon, descending upon the mountains of Sion. For there Hashem has commanded the blessing. May there be life forever.
No applause. Shh. Hatikva, Hatikva. Shh. They're applauding.